good morning. Today we are going to discuss the next topic, chemical control and coordination. Here chemical control, already we have discussed about the neural control. So we know that the neural control and the coordination process we are taking is how the neurons or the nerves, they are coordinating the body functions, all the processes of the organism, whatever it is, the functions they are carrying. So those are majorly controlled by the neural system. That comes under the neural control and coordination we are taking. Here the neural control we are taking means it is a point to point coordination system. It is a point to point coordination system. Neural control and coordination we are taking. That means one particular point where has to be need the controlling, that particular region or that particular point or that particular cell is controlling with the help of the neurons. So it is called as a point to point coordinating system, controlling system we are doing. And it is a short, it is not controlling into the continuous, short duration controlling mechanism it is. Short duration. So within a fraction of seconds, that function will be completed and control will be stops here. Okay, it is a short duration mechanism. But we are taking into the chemical control and coordination we are taking means, it is a slow process we are taking means, long duration in particular cells and tissues and their functions we are taking. Okay, a particular cells and tissues, generally these are called as the target cells. Okay, these particular cells, their controlling process, their coordination process, their functions are altered continuously for the longer duration. So neurons we are taking means nerve conduction is occurs into the fraction of seconds only. There alters into the those cellular function in a fraction of seconds and later it is disappears. But a certain cells and their function, their physiological function or their metabolic function, they has to be controlled for the longer duration. That time neural control and coordination is not at all the useful here. Okay. So instead of the neural control coordination, the certain chemicals are releasing into the body and these chemicals are controlling into the those target cell and their functions we are taking. That is comes under the chemical control. Generally, what type of the chemicals they are secreting in the body? Humans we are taking means there are two specific types of the cells. Generally, they are secretes the these chemicals we are taking according to that. Generally, these cells are called as the glandular cells, exocrinal and endocrinal. So, exocrinal glands we are taking means and their cells, endocrinal glands and their cells we are taking. Exocrine. Here, exo means outer, the crine means the depth we are taking. That means the glands which are having glands with the depth. Okay, glands with depth. So that means the glandular cells, a specific glands which are present in the body, those are secreting their secretion through the specific depth. So those glands are called exocrinal glands. Exocrinal glands here. Examples you are taking is the digestive glands, all they comes under the exocrinal glands only. Salivary glands you can take, okay. Gastric glands you can take, liver you can take, okay. So like these, all these digestive glands are comes under the exocrinal glands only. The second one is the endocrinal gland. These are the specific here. Endo means these are not having into the any glands. Their secretion is released into the endo means internal only. Endo means internal. Endo means internal. So their secretions are directly released into the blood. Inside means the blood. The blood is a carrier of the these glandular secretions we are taking means endocrinal glands we are taking. So generally these glands are not having into the any duct. So directly they are secreting into the blood through the blood, blood transmission, blood circulation. So whatever the chemicals they are secreting, they are transmitting into the target cell. They are reaching into the target cells. We are taking this. Okay. So this is a function of the endocrinal glands. We are taking. Generally, the exocrinal gland and their secretions we are taking means they are called as the enzymes. These are called as the enzymes. So generally, the exocrinal glands and their secretions called as the enzymes. The endocrinal glands and their secretions called as the hormones here. Yeah, that means hormones. The specific names we are giving. These are the enzymes and these are the hormones here. So this is a basic difference into the glandular cells in the body and their secretions we are taking into the humans. Okay. So in that too, in this topic, the chemical control and coordination we are taking means. We are discussing about the endocrinal glands and their secretion. That means the hormonal control and the coordination in the body. Okay, hormonal control and the coordination. Hormonal control and coordination. We are taking means. First of all, the hormones. How can we define the hormones? Means the modern definition, the modern scientific definition. We are taking means. Hormones are the specific chemicals. These are the specific chemicals which are produces into the minute amount, and these are non-nutrient substances. These are the non-nutrient substances and acting as a intercellular messengers here. Okay, so these are the minute in the amount. So how much amount these are producing in the body means very trace amount of quantity they are producing from the endocrinal glands. Okay, minute amount. And these are the non-nutrient substances. That means these are not involved in directly into the any nutrition process. Nutrition means directly they are not generating into the energy by the oxidation. They are not generating into the any energy here. So these are the non-nutrient substances you are taking. And these are acting as a intercellular messengers, not intrama, inter, between into the cells, and the between into the different parts of the cells. These are acting as a messengers. That means these are carrying the information. Okay, so the different part of the cells we are doing. So this is the basic definition of the hormones we are taking. Hormones means how can we define that? So these are the specific chemicals with a non-nutrient substances produces the minute amount and acting as a intracellular messengers. These are called as the hormones we are taking. And based on the chemical property, hormones we are taking means. So hormones we are taking means these are the basically three types of hormones are producing into the human body. Three types of the hormones are producing into the human body we are taking. So what are those three types of the hormones means? One is the amino hormones and second one is the peptide protein, hormones. Third one is a steroid hormones here. One by one can be discussed now. First one is the amino hormones, amino acids. That means these hormones, the amino hormones we are taking means, amino hormones we are taking means. So these are the derivatives of the amino acids only. A simple amino acids we are taking. So those type of the hormones are comes under the amino hormones here. Examples we can write into the thyroxine. Serotonin, melatonin, all these are comes under the amino hormones only. A single amino acid derivatives there, so they are producing from the a single amino acids, only the one single amino acid. So for example, the tyrosine, okay, the tyrosine. So we are taking the tyrosine we are taking, sir. This is producing from the a single amino acid. So like that as a melatonin, okay, melatonin we are taking, sir. Like that as a tryptophan we are taking. That is a so amino acid. From the derivatives only these are producing. Only the one single amino acid is so producing into the these hormones. So this comes under the amino hormones. Second one we are taking means that the peptide or the protein hormones. So how can we define that the peptide or the protein hormones means, generally some of the hormones they are producing. So 3 to 50 amino acid polypeptides of the amino acids are producing into the these hormones here. They comes under the peptidal hormones we are taking. Okay, so what are those 3 to 50 amino acids are producing? Short, that means a short polypeptidal chains are producing into the these amino acids we are taking. And the protein hormones we are taking means these are producing the 50 to 200 and the more amino acid polypeptidal chains they are making into the these amino acids we are taking means. So these are comes under the protein amino acids we are taking means. Protein amino acids. Examples you can write for the peptidyl amino acid ADH and oxytocin. So oxytocin we are taking, sir. These are comes under the peptide amino acids. And protein amino acids we are taking, sir, FSH and the LH. So these are comes under the protein amino acid form. These are producing the more the number of amino acids here. So like these, sir, these are the examples of the second category of the hormones. The third one is the steroid hormones we are taking. Steroid hormones. So these are the derivatives of the steroid groups we are taking. Means steroid group means nothing but as a cholesterol. These are the derivatives of the cholesterol here. Okay. So those type of the hormones they comes under the third category. They come they are the steroid hormones. Examples you can write into the testosterone, progesterone, estrogen. So these are comes under the steroid hormones we are taking. So like this, based on the chemical property of the hormones, these are differentiated into the amino hormones, peptidyl hormones and protein hormones and the steroid hormones. And there is the iodoform hormones is also there. Iodoform hormones. Iodoform hormones means the hormones which are derived from the iodine. Okay, iodine. So the generally we are including into the those hormones into the amino hormones only. So why it is means those hormones also producing by the a single amino acid. Example, thyroxine only. Thyroxine is the major component of the thyroxine hormone is the iodine only. Iodoform hormones there. Okay, or you can take the catecholamines. You can take. So catecholamines is producing by the a single amino acids only. Epinephrine and the norepinephrine we are taking means there also comes under the amino hormones. So these are the different examples and the different types of the hormones based on their chemical nature we are taking. Next one, endocrine glands and their secretion. That means hormones. Generally, we are taking into the human body. Both into the vertebrates and the invertebrates now. Vertebrates, we are taking, sir. Both are secreting into the these hormones we are taking. But in the case of the invertebrates, very less amount and less number of. So less number of the endocrinal glandular secretions are presented into the invertebrates because their body complexity we are taking means it is a simple complexity. So they are producing into the only the few number of the endocrinal glandular secretions here. So in the case of the vertebrates we are taking means compared to the invertebrates, these are producing into somewhat higher amount compared to these. Totally overall we are taking it is a less into the quantity only, very little quantity only endocrinal secretions are there. But compared to the invertebrates, these are producing into the more the types. That means the body complexity is going to increase in here. So the more types of more number of secretions or hormones are producing here. So these are producing into the more types of the hormones. In that too, humans we are taking, human body itself is the more complex compared to the all remaining other vertebrates. The human body is producing the different types of the hormones with the help of the these endocrine glands. Generally, what are the endocrine glands that are presented into the human body? We are taking means one by one can be discussed. Ma. So generally we are taking means. From the top to bottom, we are take means hypothalamus, pituitary, pineal, thyroid, parathyroid. Thymus, adrenal, and gonadic. So these are the major endocrinal parts in the human body. We are. What are those? Hypothalamus is producing, pituitary gland, pineal gland, thyroid gland, parathyroid gland, thymus gland, adrenaline gland, and the gonadic glands and their secretion. So all these are comes under the endocrinal glands here. So one by one can be discussed in these glands and their positions and their secretions and what is the functions of those glands and what is the advantages and the disadvantages of those glands and their secretions we are taking means. Actually, here the hormones, the secretions of the endocrine we are taking means. A certain amount of the secretions are producing into the these glands we are taking, their cells we are taking. The amount of secretion. The amount of secretion we are taking means this amount of the secretion, whether it is increased, or decreased. So yeah, that means, sir, whether it is increased hypersecretion, whether it is decreased hyposecretion, we call as a hyposecretion here. Whether some amount, with constant amount only, generally they are secreting. Whether the secretion content is becomes into the higher, more secretions are producing. Hypersecretion disorders are forming, diseases are forming into the hormonal imbalance. Suppose the required quantity, less amount it is secreted, it leads into the hyposecretion. Disorders are forming in the case of the human body. So like this, the amount of the secretions of the hormones, they are take means, they influencing into the body functions and causing into the different abnormalities in the body we are taking. So one by one we can be discuss into the these endocrinal glands and their secretion. First one is a hypothalamus. Here. So whether we are taking into the hypothalamus, suppose this is into the brain. We are taking means these are the cerebral hemispheres. And this is into the diencephalon region. The floor of the diencephalon. Okay? The floor. This is a part of the forebrain only. Diencephalon we are taking means, it is a part of the forebrain. The floor of the diencephalon we are taking means, so thalamus, epithalamus, hypothalamus. There are the three regions are presented here. So epithalamus, hypothalamus here. So the floor of the diencephalon is called as a hypothalamus. This is nothing but as a floor of the diencephalon only. That is, so bottom side of the brain, the forebrain region. So whatever it is, the structure is there. So that is forming by the hypothalamus. So in this hypothalamus is secreting into the some secretions. It producing into the some secretion. Why it is means, sir? Actually, hypothalamus is acting as a neurochemical coordinator. That means, nervous system with the chemical coordinate system, these two systems are integrated by the hypothalamus only. So generally this is the position of the hypothalamus we are taking. That is a floor of the forebrain or the floor of the diencephalon region we are taking. So whether we are taking into the hypothalamus, how it is produced means, it is ectodermal in the origin. That means, the embryonic stage, we are taking the outer layer is developing as a hypothalamus. We are ectodermal in the origin. So in this hypothalamus, neurochemical are secreted here. So these are secreted into the neurochemicals. So whether you are taking into the hypothalamus, this is the position of the hypothalamus. Now floor it is forming. And majorly this hypothalamus region we are taking means producing into the different types of the stimulating hormones and inhibiting hormones. These are producing into the stimulus. Two types of the hormones are secreting into the hypothalamus. We are taking means. So one is the stimulating hormones. Other one is the inhibiting hormones here. So stimulating hormones means these hormones are accelerating into the remaining other glands of the body, the other secretions of the body. So those are comes under the stimulating hormone. The inhibiting hormones are comes under the. So these are nothing but as a these are suppressed or inhibited the other glandular and their secretions. So these are comes under the inhibitory so hormones. Examples we are taking means we are taking growth stimulating hormone somatostatin. Okay, so growth inhibiting hormone somatostatin. Okay. Generally, these two hormones we are taking means one is influencing, that means either the secretions of the growth hormone somatotropin we are taking means growth hormone generally called as a growth hormone. The growth somatotropin and their secretions are influencing by the controlling by the these two hormones somatocrinin and the somatostatin we are taking. So these two hormones are releasing from hypothalamus only. So like this growth regulating hormone, generally these are called, these two are called as a GRH, growth regulating hormones. Like that as a, so that means ACTH. This ACTH is the secretions of the pituitary gland actually. So it is also controlled by the adrenocorticotropic hormone, that means adrenal hormone is regulated. ARH we are taking means this is called as the ARH, adrenal regulating adrenocorticotropic, so releasing hormone that is regulating by the ARH hormone. Okay, so this ARH adrenocorticotropic releasing regulatory hormone we are taking, it is also producing from the hypothalamus. So what is the function of the ARH means? It regulates into the ACTH synthesis we are taking, secretion we are taking means adrenocorticotropes, they are stimulating by the these secretions of the hypothalamus here. Okay, so like this the body, so many stimulating hormones and the inhibiting hormones are producing from the hypothalamus we are taking. So these are two types of the hormones are secreted into the hypothalamus. Then how these hypothalamus secretions are releases into the body means whether you are taking into the hypothalamus, it is dorsal side is extended or is connected with the a glandular structure is called as a pituitary gland we are taking. Through the pituitary gland, the hypothalamus secretions, whatever it is produces, those are secreted out. So through the pituitary gland and their lobes, we are dermis. The pituitary gland is connected with the hypothalamus with a stocky structure is called as the infundibulum. Here we are dermis, hypophyseal portal system. This is nothing but as a what type of the blood capillary system. Portal system means blood capillary system only. Okay, so this blood capillary system is connected with the hypothalamus with the anterior lobe of the pituitary. So through this portal system, the secretions of the hypothalamus is releases into the body, or they are going to stimulates into the pituitary gland. They are regulating into the pituitary gland. There is one more. Here the hypothalamus we are taking means neural cells are presented. Neural cells, the modified hormonal secreting the neural cells are presented. Generally these are called as a nuclei cells are presented here. So these nuclear cells, these are the specific modified nerve cells which are presented the hypothalamus region, and here these are able to secrete into the stimulating or the inhibiting hormone, and they are storing into the their axons and the their terminals. Okay, so whenever it is required, that time these are releasing. So through the neurohypophysis we are diagnosing, through the directly the hypothalamus we are diagnosing, the posterior, the hypothalamus directly releasing into the these secretions, the nuclear secretions directly into the body. So through the posterior lobe of the pituitary, that one we can be discussing the pituitary gland. So discussion we are, so like this, the specific cells are presented into the hypothalamus, those only they are secreting into the these different types of the stimulating hormones and the inhibit. So what are the examples of these stimulating hormones and the inhibiting hormones, different types and their functions, one by one we can be studying. The hypothalamus stimulating and the inhibiting hormone, one by one. First one is the ARH, adrenocorticotropic releasing hormone, regulatory hormone it is. So what is the function of in this ARH means it regulates the ACTH secretion, adrenal corticotropic hormone. So the cortical region of the adrenal gland and their secretions, okay, is control under the control of the ARH only. Actually it is a stimulating hormone, it stimulates into the ACTH secretion in the body we are taking from the adrenal gland we are taking. So that is a major one. It is released from the hypothalamus only. And the TRH, that is a thymus, so thymus regulating hormone, sorry, thyroid regulating hormone. So the thyroid secretion and this the thyroid gland and their secretions we are doing thyroxine. So those are influencing by, their secretions are influencing by, the thyroid gland is influencing by the TRH only. So whenever it is producing, that time the thyroid gland is becomes into the active and it stores into the secretions of the their specific secretions we are doing thyroxine we are taking. So that is under the control of the TRH only. It is also producing from the hypothalamus. Like that I say, GHRH we are taking, growth hormone regulatory hormone here, or growth hormone releasing hormone. Okay, so here releasing, that means the secretions, the growth hormone, somatotropin we are taking, means that is producing under the influence of the GHRH only. So whenever it is needed to produce into the growth hormone, that time from the hypothalamus GHRH is releases here. And the another one is called as a growth hormone inhibiting hormone. It inhibits into the growth hormone and their secretion after the reaching of the certain age into the individuals we are taking. Growth hormone early stages into the so human their development we are taking, growth hormone is continuously secreted here in the lower ages we are taking. Up to reaching to the certain age into the humans we are taking, means it going to stops or it going to inhibits by a hormonal action, that is called as a GHIH here, growth inhibiting hormone, or it is also called as a growth inhibiting peptide here. Okay, so peptide or the hormone, it regulates or that decreases into the growth hormonal secretion we are taking. So these two are related to the growth of the individual. And this is called as a PRH, means prolactin releasing hormone. While the time of the after the pregnancy, after the delivery we are taking, so in the after the pregnancy we are taking, after the delivery of the newborn children, the prolactin is released, the secretions of the prolactin is released under the control of the PRH only. Their concentrations are going to increasing here. So what is the use of this prolactin, means it stimulates into the ejection of the milk. The milk ejection is under the control of the PRH only. The prolactin is synthesized, prolactin when it is needed, so that time the prolactin concentrations are going to increase by the PRH only. Like that as a, it is also controlled by the P PIH, prolactin inhibitory hormone here. That means it decreases into the prolactin after the a certain duration we are. Like that as a MSH, melanocyte stimulating hormone, releasing hormone. Okay, so melanocytes are activated from the hypothalamus secretion, that is comes under the melanocyte releasing hormone is produces from the hypo. Like that is the inhibitory hormone. These are inhibiting into the melanocytes here, that is into the pineal gland cells you are taking. Like that is a gonadotrophic releasing hormone, gonads, gonadotrophic releasing hormone. Gonadic secretions you are taking. The gonadic secretions are under the control of the GnRH. All these are the secretions of the hypothalamus. So that only the hypothalamus is called as a super commander of the body. Why we call as a super commander? All the commands are coming from hypothalamus only, or it is also called as a central controlling center. Okay, so central control, that is the central means here controlling center. So from here only, from here whatever the secretions are releasing from the hypothalamus, those only controlling into the all the secretions, that means all the endocrine secretions of the body. Okay, so it is called as a super commander of the body here. So this is the one gland, so one endocrine gland of the body we are taking, that is the hypothalamus.